Seek him who made the Pleiades and Orion, and turns deep darkness into the morning, and darkens the day into night, who calls for the waters of the sea and pours them out upon the surface of the earth. The Lord is his name.
Our God makes speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalms 81 and 82.
Sing with joy to God our strength, and raise a loud shout to the God of Jacob.
Raise a song and sound the timbre, the medley and the lyre.
Blow the ram's horn at the new moon, and at the full moon the day of our feast.
For this is a statute for Israel, the Lord of the God of Jacob.
He laid it as a solemn charge upon Joseph, when he came out of the land of Egypt.
I heard an unfamiliar voice saying, I eased his shoulder from the burden, his hands were set free from bearing the load.
You called me in trouble, and I saved you. I answered you from the secret place of thunder, and tested you at the waters of Meribah.
Hear, O my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, if you would but listen to me,
there shall be no strange god among you. You shall not worship a foreign god.
I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, and said, open your mouth wide, and I will fill it.
And yet my people did not hear my voice, and Israel would not obey me.
So I gave them over to the stubbornness of their hearts, to follow their own devices.
Oh, that my people would listen to me, that Israel would walk in my way.
I should soon subdue their enemies, and turn my hand against their foes.
Those who hate the Lord would cringe before him, and their punishment would last forever.
But Israel would I feed with the finest wheat, and satisfy him with honey from the rock.
God takes his stand in the council of heaven. He gives judgment in the midst of the gods.
How long will you judge unjustly, and show favor to the wicked?
Save the weak and the orphan. Defend the humble and needy.
Rescue the weak and the poor. Deliver them from the power of the wicked.
They do not know, neither do they understand. They go about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are shaken.
Now I say to you, you are gods, and all of you children of the Most High.
Nevertheless, you shall die like mortals, and fall like any prince.
Arise, O God, and rule the earth. For you shall take all nations for your
glory. To the Father, and to the Son,
Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no one, and was appalled that there was no one to intervene. So his own arm brought him victory, and his righteousness upheld him. He put on righteousness like a breastplate, a helmet of salvation on his head. He put on garments of vengeance for clothing, and wrapped himself in fury as in a mantle. According to their deeds, so will he repay. Wrath to his adversaries, requital to his enemies. To the coastlands he will render requital. So those in the west shall fear the name of the Lord, and those in the east his glory. For he will come like a pent-up stream, that the wind of the Lord drives on. And he will come to Zion as a redeemer, to those in Jacob who turn from transgression, says the Lord. And as for me, this is my covenant with them, says the Lord. My spirit that is upon you, and the words that I have put in your mouth, shall not depart out of your mouth, or out of the mouths of your children, or out of the mouths of your children's children, says the Lord, from now on and forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Respexit Dominus, humilitatem meam, et fecit in me magna, qui potens est. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. For he has looked with favour on his glorious servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy. The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Respexit Dominus,
humilitatem meam, et fecit in me magna, qui potens est.
The letter to the Romans, the 12th chapter, beginning at the first verse. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, which is good and acceptable and perfect. By the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we who are many are one body in Christ, and individually members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you who now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Saviour, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten.
was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care,
and guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth,
your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten,
nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the Church, and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.
Amen.